Well, the interesting thing to me is that far from undermining my faith, your work in mythology has liberated my faith from the cultural prisons to which it had been sentenced.
It liberated my own. I know it's going to do it with everybody who really gets the message. Every mythology, every religion is true in this sense. It is true as metaphorical of the human and cosmic mystery. But when it gets stuck to the metaphor, then you're in trouble.
The metaphor being?
Well, Jesus ascended to heaven. The story is he ascended bodily to heaven. The story is that his mother, still alive, asleep, ascended to heaven. So this is metaphorical of something. You don't have to throw it away. All you have to find is what it's saying.
What do you think it is saying?
What it's saying is he didn't go out there. He went in here, which is where you must go too, and ascend to heaven through the inward space to that source from which you and all life came. That's the sense of that.
But aren't you undermining one of the great cardinal doctrines of the traditional classic Christian faith, the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus prefiguring our own and overcoming the body with a higher physical truth?
Well, that would be what I would call the mistaken reading of the symbol. That's reading it in terms of prose instead of in terms of poetry. That's reading a metaphor in terms of the denotation instead of in terms of the connotation. You understand that? It's a purely literary problem.
The poetry gets to the unseen reality.
That which is beyond even the concept of reality. It's that which transcends all thought. It's putting you there all the time. And in some way, giving you a line to connect with that mystery which you are. And the myths do it, by gosh, they do it.